In this segment, we'll be talking about the solar sink. And here on the wall, we've got a Pro-C conventional controller hooked up with a solar sink module installed inside and the solar sink sensor up here on the wall. The solar sink system is an add-on addition to your base controller. The solar sink sensor measures solar radiation and temperature, and you'll pick one of the four region selections to choose from in the owner's manual based on your peak July and August temperature. That will be part of the programming that I'll show you in a moment. But once you've selected your region, the solar sink will measure solar radiation and temperature and adjust your controller's programming based on that variance. The solar sink sensor also has a rain and freeze click portion built in. So if the temperatures drop below 37 degrees, it'll prevent watering, or if it rains, it'll physically stop the controller from watering, just like a regular rain click would do. But otherwise, the solar sink sensor and module is an add-on to the base controller. You can add it on to the ACC controller, the ICC controller, both series of Pro-C as well as the new X-Core controller or the new I-Core controller. So for the programming portion of the solar sink, you need to start with the base controller. And there's two key pieces of this. Number one, you want to ensure that your seasonal adjust is at 100% to start out. It's very important. See, in this case, it's at 75%. So we want to use the plus button on the season adjust to increase that to 100%. And we'll leave it right there at 100. It's very important. On this new PCC series, you'll find that the seasonal adjustment is here on the face pack. Other controllers may have an up and down triangle next to the display. This is the older version with the season adjust to the left of the display. Or it might be within the firmware, for example, in the ACC. But you want to start out at 100% on day one. Number two, we're going to set this controller up for the maximum runtime that you'll ever need in the month of July and August. So you need to decide or be aware of how long it is you think your runtimes for your stations is going to be in the month of July. That's the time that you want to put in. It might be February or March right now, I understand, and you don't normally run, say, 30 minutes for the rotors in your lawn in the month of, you know, February or March. If you're programming this in the springtime and you're only putting the appropriate runtime for the springtime, you won't get enough runtime come summertime. So you need to put in right now the maximum runtime that you'll ever use for your individual stations when you first set this up. So as long as your season adjust is at 100 and you have your maximum station runtime, you also select your set days to water and your start times as though you would in the middle of the summer. Once those ingredients are set on the controller, your start times and your days to water will never change. If you select Monday, Wednesday, Friday, it's still going to water Monday, Wednesday, Friday. If you say start at 6 a.m., it's going to start at 6 a.m. The only difference is the solar sink will adjust the runtime due to the season adjust. If you have 20 minutes in here for a runtime and it's at 100% today, the solar sink may adjust that down over the next few days to, say, 80%. And that 80% would come out to being, instead of 20 minutes, about 16 minutes, for example. So you need to start with your maximum runtime in the month of July in the phase pack and at 100%. The runtime is the only thing that gets adjusted, not your starts and not your days to water.